Did you know that a 10-meter platform diver covers the last 7 meters they fall in less time than the first 3? Actually, this also applies to a falling rock, but rocks aren't nearly as good looking. Anyway, by the time a diver, or rock, has fallen 3 meters, they're already going about 17 miles an hour, and as they fall farther, they continue to pick up speed so that they cover the remaining distance in less time. But now suppose a world record sprinter races our Olympic diver. That is, Usain Bolt starts 10 meters from the finish line, and the diver starts 10 meters above it. Who gets there first? Well, Bolt's actual running time through the first 10 meters of his world record was 1.74 seconds, while a rock falling 10 meters takes only 1.43 seconds. So, victory to the rock by a slim margin. But of course, an Olympic diver is not a rock, and in particular, they jump upwards off the platform. This means they'll be in the air for an additional third of a second, or a total of about 1.78 seconds before they hit the water. So it's actually a close race, and Bolt wins the photo finish. However, while we continue to be amazed by how fast Usain Bolt is, the fact that he could beat a diver in freefall is more of a reminder that while gravity is a law of nature, it doesn't give you a blazing start. That's why it's easiest to catch something in the first instant after you drop it. If you wait even a second, it'll be 15 feet down and already traveling 20 miles an hour. Bye-bye.